Do the blinds need to go up or something?
No, I don't think so. You can.
Too much light.
Yeah, go ahead. Good morning, everybody. Here, we're trying to get the lighting situation fixed here. So, it's like mood lighting. So I'm here with my client Sandy, and she has really short hair, and I'll show you. Good morning, everybody. Got a pair in my mouth. So Sandy is a friend of mine.
Hi.
And she has short hair, and I usually paint her. We used to do foil highlighting, so you can see how it's grown. So Ray J Hart wore. Yeah, Jody. Y'all give me some hearts. Hey, Robin. So short hair is always really tricky to paint. And I know a lot of you, I get messages a lot on people scared of attacking short hair. It's really not as hard as you think. And we have gone to where I do dark and light in her hair. So she's agreed to let me do a little bit of periscoping, just showing y'all some tricks to do. So I have my, and sorry if I don't answer your questions, because I have, it's hard to focus, but you can ask them. And if I don't answer, you can always send me a message on Facebook. I'm looking forward to seeing you too. So here is my lightener. You can see it's really thick. Okay, I'll send you some pictures. Nothing But Pixies is a very, very popular Instagram, and he says, send me some after pictures. It's an Instagram that's really popular. Okay, anyway, see how I get sidetracked? So my lightener is really thick. You can see how that is. So, hey, Billie Jean. So, give me a second, and I left my, one of my students, Tracy Fite, gave me a tripod for these situations. And what do you know? I left it at home. But I do have my selfie stick, which I got from another lovely girl named Ashley Johnson, which y'all probably follow her. So hang on just a second. And we have that. Oh, yeah, that's better. So I'm trying to see if this is too far away. Let's see. Maybe right there. Okay, so a lot of times what I see, what lightener are I using? I'm using, oh, thank you. They love my dress. I can tell you about the dress later. Anyway, I'm using Solaris. That is my go-to, but you can use anything. There's Candy Shaw has Sunlights, there's Well of Free Lights, there's all kinds of stuff out there. So I'm just using this little clip here. Instead of clipping everything in little sections, it's just sometimes easier for me to focus on one area. So, and under here, I want to keep a little blonder around her face, so I'm going to do just that little piece. And I like to lay that lightener on my hand, and I'm just doing just light little pieces right here. You want to keep the blonde kind of how it frames your face right here, or you want it to stay dark?
Whatever you think.
She says, whatever I think. I don't want to color her face. So that just gives her a little nice face frame right there without giving her a ton of blonde. We just want a little bit. And then I'm giving little, hang on. Okay. If you forget you have color on your finger and you touch the hair, you just have to wipe it off. So hang on a sec, I need a towel. Okay. Let's see. Tell Amanda I said hi. Somebody says, sure, complexion is amazing.
Oh, it's she must have a filter on it. I guess these are my 15 minutes of fame. But thank you.
So in here, I'm just doing little pieces. You know how it's like, one of the things we struggle with short. Yeah, good lighting. One of the things we struggle with short hair is having that blonde where it doesn't have a line. You never want those. Your client has a beautiful face. You get lots of compliments. See? This is a good, we should take pictures right now, right? Yeah, she is beautiful.
Oh. Yeah, for a meemaw.
A meemaw? Yes. Doesn't even seem possible.
A northerner named Meemaw. That's interesting.
All right, so in here you can see I've got a little more blonde left from the last time. So again, I want to see some blonde pieces. And you'll see this is a little bit different kind of painting than normal. You know, a lot of times I do the full panel. So now I'm just doing like little pieces here and there.
If this starts shaking, you have to let me know.
Yeah, let me know if your hand gets tired. And we're not going to do the whole head like this. I'm just going to...
I just don't want to make people seasick.
Oh. Let's see. This is exactly what I needed to watch. Awesome. Let's see. There. Let's see. Okay. For her, if I do a full panel, it would still look good, but... Yeah, Tracy Fight needs to come back and watch this. I wish I had brought that tripod she gave me. So, I'm doing... I would call these small full panels, or little streaks through the hair, but they won't look stripy. So now I'm going to come in here. This is like part of what makes it work. This is a color. I'm using a 7N from Goldwell. I don't know if you can see how I'm just taking little, I'll grab the camera and show you up close what I'm doing. Let's see. Ah. Give her hand a break. So can you see how I'm doing that? Oh. Color on her face again. Okay, so basically I've got, you know, some light around her face, and I'm gonna just do in sections that all the way up. We're trying to get away from so much blonde in the back, and it helps to break up
the natural color,
because her natural color is darker. So when we were doing the blonde, a lot of times, you know, with her, because the 7 is, you know, it's a level 7. If I were doing something really dramatic, I may put those low lights in a foil or an MB mesh. But yes, I'm cutting as well today. Let's see, how do you prevent from bleeding? You know, I don't know. I never really have any problem with the dark and the blonde bleeding. But I think it's because when I lay down the next section, it's going to lay down just softly on top of her hair. Or on top of this layer. So I never have any problem with bleeding on this. If I'm doing somebody with a lot of blonde, then I may get some bleeding. So anyway, let me see if I can, I might just can prop this up right here. Hang on a second. I can come back in a little while, or I can see if I can prop this thing up if you want me to stay. I don't know how exciting this will be to watch the whole thing, but oh, you know what? I think I can make this work. I'm using a towel. Let's see, I haven't found a good bleach. Sorry. Oh, this will work. Look. Yay!
Yay!
Okay. So, I don't know if it's going to show you real well, but I'm going to do my best. And I probably won't stay on here too long, but 7N... On high, yeah, 7N, I'm using in between here, so like it helps to break it up. So I'm gonna do another section. I'm doing about about as thick as my finger section. And again, we kind of light the blonde around the face. So, hang on just a second. So there's the panel. I'm going to do a dark right here just again to break it up. And another one.
Boom.
Is anybody there going to be at my class in Westchester this weekend? Sandy's actually from that area. Are you actually from Westchester or?
No, Delaware County. Oh,
okay.
But I rode out in Chad's Ford. So Westchester was just stomping grounds between Concord and Chad's Ford.
It sounds like a really neat little town.
It's wonderful. Beautiful. The countryside is just amazing.
Oh, really? I kind of, in my head, I have it pictured like, you know, like a Maine or something. I don't know why. It's probably not, but it kind of looks like that to me. All right, so again, see how that kind of looks? It just breaks it up. So, like, underneath, I've got the light, like, right under there and under there. Oh, you can't see. So under that dark, there's a light piece. And then when I go to the next level, that'll kind of just, I just scatter it around and it just ends up looking really, really pretty. And you can see as I get to the top, she's a little blonder. Slouch. Slouch, girl, slouch.
Forget what your mother told you, right?
Yes, I always say I'm going to ask you to do something your mother taught you not to do. Slouch. All right. Yeah, sometime in my classes, I forget about short hair. I'm using a 40 volume with my lightener. And with my color 7N, I'm using 10. See how when I lay that down, I'm just laying it really lightly, so it's not like I don't want it to lay heavy on that, just a little bit. Also, guys, you know, like once the lightener is on my hand, and she's a beautiful client. It gets a little bit soft if it's sitting on your hand too long. I don't like to use it when it's that soft. So I'll take that off and just put it on the side of my bowl. I just kind of knock it on the side of my bowl over here so it's sitting there, and then I grab some fresh.
So the heat from your hand.
Yeah, the heat from your hand kind of melts it. I kind of always say it's like buttercream icing. It kind of melts. And I'll hold the camera up in a minute so y'all can see how the placement is here. make your chair pink again.
I don't know. Maybe I have it up too high.
Oh. Well, well, well. Let's see. Yes, clay-based lightener. What lightener are you using? It's okay. I'm using Solaris clay-based lightener with 40 volume. Yes, Solaris. I'm a fan. But, you know, Sandy and I were just talking about this earlier. You know, one of the things in my classes, I don't tell you you have to use Solaris. It's just my preference, but there's lots of lighteners you can use out there. There's Candy Shaw has Sunlights. There's somebody says Sandy.
Do they know? I don't know.
I couldn't see who that was. Who said Sandy? It could have been somebody you know.
I don't know.
Who was it that said Sandy? Do you know Sandy? Let's see, how does it compare to free lights? Hey, Mandy.
Oh, Mandy. Yeah, guess who's here?
I like Solaris better. That's just my personal opinion. Because it's really smooth. Hey, Pamela. I like the texture of it a lot better because it's smooth. And also, I have an allergy to sunlights and free lights, so I don't know what's in them that causes me to have allergies, but I do. So, okay, here, let me hold this up. I'm going to go in just a minute so I can, here, let me take the phone off this thing. Hang on, I'm going to drop the phone. Yay. I think I hung, oh, I didn't hang up. I thought I did. Okay, man, that's hard to get off. Hang on. Okay, so I used a comb last time. I did short hair painting. Yeah, that's a great way too. So here you can kind of see, I do like little streaks. I mean, they're not teeny little streaks, but it gives like some depth in her hair. Also, it helps give some pop, you know, where I've taken it through. Because it's already blonde, but we always like a little more pop, right?
Always.
Always. And I'm trying to keep a little blonde pop around her face so you can see that. So, where she parts is going to be over here. So when I come up to there, I mean, I'll just kind of do the same thing all the way up this side, and I'll probably continue on right here another couple sections, and then I'll work up this side. And then in the back, what I do is I've already kind of started here. But I'll pull up this section and then just do some dark, and I'll do some light, and it'll look really pretty. So anyway, hopefully that helps. I will come back later and show you how it looks. So just keep an eye out. No, everything just kind of blends. It just blends pretty well. But I'll show you the result in a little bit. I'm going to finish her up and let her process, and I'll see y'all a little later. Bye. Thanks for joining.